Sky is the limit means you have no limit. This blue thing you see above you is the trap light that is trapped in the atmosphere, and it appears blue. If you pass that, there's nothing blue there. All you see is what you see here, and the sun would be right between here on the 23rd day of September. Now watch this good. Look at it good. That's planet Earth there. That's it here. And this is the Virgin constellation Virgo. And that's the sun. Now, on the 23rd day of September around there, what happens? What I'm going to do, watch it good. I'm aligning the Earth with the sun. See the Earth here? And here's the sun. Now I'm going to place the Earth as if we're on the Earth and we're looking at the sun. So that means I could take the Earth as if I'm placing it right in the middle of the sun. Okay, bam. Now, you will notice now, from this angle, you get this sort of impression as if the sun is just underneath of the Virgin's head. That's the Virgin here, if you never got it good. That's her legs here. This is her body, physical. Her arms stretched out like this, and this is her head. She's literally lying on her back with her legs open as a woman ready to give birth to a child. So this is what is really taking place here. So now, you'll notice, as I said, here is the Earth. Now, that means if you were on planet Earth, well, I hope you were, and on this day you were looking at the sun, it would appear as if the sun is inside of this constellation just because of the position. This is why even on the next level, the moon, because of course the moon comes out in the night, so it's easier for you to see the stars. So let me just show you quickly now. So this is September. Let us move now September, and we look at October. Now, let us look at this from a different angle. You see it here. This is the very same Virgin, basically the same time. Here's the sun. We're looking at it from a different angle now. We're actually watching this from the literal Earth as such. Now, as I said, this is the 23rd day also of September. Now, this is a constellation of Libra. I want you to watch this good enough. Here is the sun. As you can see, it's basically at the feet of the Virgin. A moment ago, you saw it here at the head. Watch it good. As it moves, it's at the feet. The next month, you notice it finds itself passing through Libra and passing through what you call the Scorpion. All right, very important information here. Now, when you read in your Bible, in the book of Revelation chapter 12, Revelation specifically says, and everyone give me their ear, Revelation specifically said, this is John the Revelator, and keep in mind a revelation now, it's known as the revelation of John the Divine, because the revelation itself now is the apocalypse. All the prophets had a revelation, not just one individual, believe it. That is just the revelation that remained in the book. So at the same time now, Revelation chapter 12 says that there was a woman in heaven, and she was clothed with the sun, and the moon was under her feet. And there was a red dragon that stood before this woman, angry and ready to devour the man-child of the woman as soon as the man-child was born. Because the woman was crying in travail. But yet still now, the scripture goes on to say that, well, even though the dragon was standing in front of the woman to destroy the man-child, God had mercy on the woman and the man child that was to be born, that was to rule the earth with the rod of iron. And it said now that the same dragon cast water out of his mouth trying to flood away the woman. But the Almighty opened the earth and crushed the dragon and prepared two great wings for the woman that she could fly away to safety. And it was the same man-child that eventually ruled with the rod of iron. Alright. Revelation chapter 12. Now, this is why now I say all the time, if you know your Bible and you do not know your history, if you know your Bible and you do not know your astronomy, if you know your Bible and you don't know your chemistry, your biology, even your psychology, the knowledge of your Bible will become a mystery. You can't tell me you're reading Bible as if it's a coloring book you're looking into. You have to be ready up here. Don't play around now. We have to be serious. That's a slavery mentality. As if, oh, just the Bible and beginning to end and I don't need nothing else. I mean, come on. You think God is going to take pity on you for that? People will perish for a lack of knowledge. We can't pretend we're ignorant and we're sticking our heads in the ground like an ostrich because we can't see nobody. Nobody can see us. Now we have to get out of that mentality. John the Revelator said that the woman was clothed with the